Just been speaking of not only your life and their inner manifestation, intelligence, but are also made up of the same factors. By means of this apparatus, it is possible to verify and demonstrate that in each of the three transitory results of common cosmic processes having outwardly nothing in common, exactly the same reciprocal actions take place, ensuing each from the other to constitute one common functioning, and that it requires the evolutionary and involutionary properties of the law of heptapharmacia. The action at any certain intermediate stage in the total functioning of one of these results influences the action at each separate intermediate stage in another, exactly as in its own functioning, and furthermore that with respect to the properties of the vibrations of which they are constituted, these transitory cosmic results have complete affinity. This complete affinity in the inner reciprocal relations of these three transitory results which have outwardly nothing in common is proved in the following way. For example, a colored ray reflected upon an active element of opium transformed it into another active element corresponding in its newly acquired vibrations to those of the colored ray which had acted upon it. And then, instead of the colored ray, corresponding vibrations of sound from the strings of the zendo were directed upon the same active element, the same result was obtained. Further, if any colored ray remained to pass through any active element of opium, then, in passing through it, this same ray would have been restored. Namely, that color whose vibrations corresponded to those of this active element, or if any colored ray was made to pass through the sound vibrations still resounding at that moment from any corresponding string of the zendo, then, in passing through this wave, it took on another color, corresponding to the vibrations produced by the given string. Finally, if a specific colored ray and specific sound vibrations were simultaneously directed upon any active element of opium from among those having a lower number of vibrations than the sum of the vibrations of the colored ray and of the sound, then this active element of opium was transformed into another, the number of whose vibrations corresponded exactly to the sum of the two differently caused vibrations, and so on and so forth. This incomparable experimental apparatus likewise demonstrated that the higher vibrations of one result always give the direction to the lower vibrations of others, and the glory cosmic results. After all you have just been told, my boy, you can now be given that information thanks to which there might be crystallized in your mentation data for understanding what sort of results proceeded from the tenacious and impartial conscious labors of these saintly twin brothers, the great terrestrial scientists, and also for understanding the extent to which the being reason in the presence of your unfortunate favorites has progressively deteriorated. And so, for the second time in the course of my observations of the existence of these three-brained beings who have taken your fancy, there arose in this sweet white young China, thanks to the twin brothers, those great terrestrial scientists, an independent branch of genuine science, that is, some of the information concerning a special question, thoroughly cognized by the perfected reason of three-brained beings of earlier epochs in the given case. Concerning the fundamental law of the sacred heptapharmacia, then called the Law of Ninefoldness. And during the first two or three centuries after the sacred, as to our know of the great twin brothers, this great normally in an unchanged form from generation to generation, but it was gradually worked out in greater detail thanks to their followers, also genuine learned beings, and became accessible to the perception of even ordinary beings. And this happened chiefly because they maintained the practice established by the learned beings of the continent of Atlantis, of handing down such information to beings of subsequent generations only their genuine initiates. Here, likewise, I cannot fail to remark and declare with conviction that indeed, if this long-established practice had been maintained, even automatically, in the process of existence of these unfortunate free-brained beings who have taken your fancy, with some of true information already thoroughly assimilated by the beings of their skills, relatively normal ancestors might have remained intact and might have become the inheritance of your contemporary favorites, and moreover, those of them who constantly strive not to become complete victims of the consequences of the organ honeybuffer, the person for them might have taken advantage of this information with the aim of easing their now almost impossible inner struggle. The two of them are all more or less conscious, relatively independent individuals of our great megalocosmos, and to the misfortune of all the free-brained beings arising on this world-based planet of yours, after two or three of their centuries of blessings created for them by their great ancestors, thanks to their conscious labor and intentional suffering, gradually began to be distorted and ultimately almost totally destroyed. This follows from two causes. The first is that, owing to the same abnormal conditions of the free-being existence they themselves established, certain of them became responsible to being that special psycho-organic beings, which in their speech might be formulated thus, and irresistible to those who are considered learned by beings around them like themselves. And this psycho-organic being began to engender in them this strange tendency I have spoken about many times, which they call cunning wise acting. Bear in mind once and for all that whenever I use the expression learned beings in new formation, I refer to those of your favorites who are afflicted with special inheritance. The other cause is that under certain external circumstances of that period not depending on them, but ensuing from common cosmic processes, chiefly in the action of the law of Zodio-Onentius, the being matter-crystallized in them for engendering the ellipsis, sensitivity, and foresight, weakened in the common presence of genuine initiated beings, and they began to accept into their midst these types of new formation, and to initiate them into certain true information which totality of which was known to them alone from that time on. This branch of genuine knowledge, coming the possession of so many, began gradually to be distorted and once again was almost entirely forgotten. I use the word almost when a relatively normal process of being existence had been re-established, certain fragments of the totality of this objectively unfortunate new information again began to be handed down exclusively through genuine initiates and, passing down unchanged from one generation to another, which even your contemporary favorites will only a very limited number of them. Most of your contemporary favorites, however, received from all this true knowledge, is even thoroughly cognized by their great and remote ancestors.
Scientific attainments that we all know and do not know the names of these
insights obtained by the reason of living beings of ancient China, which has reached contemporary beings. Knowledge relating to the color combination of colors. This information is transmitted almost continuously from generation to generation. Year by year, it was progressively distorted. It was barely 2 centuries ago it was finally forgotten. At the present time, some information related to this law is still passed. Now, this is a known only concerning free-brain beings with the community name, Persia, forever. Now that the influence of the famous modern European painting has automatically spread more and more widely throughout this community, one must of course expect, as our esteemed teacher would say, with meaning and spirit, collaboration and information. I must tell you about this in as much detail as possible. First of all, this information will help you understand the laws of vibrations in which all the details of the sacred heptagram archino can be observed and recognized. And also because I brought it with me, among other objects intentionally manufactured by your favorite spirits in their ordinary daily existence. Sound-producing instrument, called a piano, on which the strings that generate vibrations are arranged and connected in the same way as on a zenko, that is, the silent principle on the famous experimental apparatus, on a coffin, created by the great brothers. I will demonstrate to you on this piano what is called the order of succession of the processes of reciprocal blending of vibrations. And thanks to my practical explanation, you will be able more easily to represent to yourself and approximately understand just how and in what order the process of the great Rogelado takes place in our great macrocosmos, and in what way the large and small cosmic concentrations arise. While telling you about this third fragment relating to the practical results, the ancient from knowledge derived an automatically reached contemporary favorites. I will start by explaining more precisely the same law of vibrations, which was first formulated by the great brothers as the law of the seven centers of gravity of vibrations themselves. I have already said at the beginning how that the reality of true information or fragment of genuine knowledge was being handed down from the beings of one generation to another through genuine initiates alone. Not only did the exact meaning put into it remain unchanged in its entirety, but thanks to other genuine learned beings among their followers, it began to be worked out in greater detail, and even became accessible to the perception of ordinary free-brain terrestrial beings. Among these followers, about a century and a half after the sacred reservoir known as the sacred brothers, was a certain genuine learned being by the name of Hugh, on the basis of the principle of construction of the middle part of the apparatus on the coffin, named Zenko, propounded a very detailed theory called the theory of the evolution and involution of vibrations. And to confirm this theory, he made a special experimental apparatus which he named Lab Burt's Note, and which later, by the way, also became known to almost all the learned beings of our great megalocosmos. This apparatus, Lab Burt's Note, like the middle part of possessive of a very strong gray mottled, gray wendy string or stretch, made from the tail hairs and head of various water-jetting hair. One end of each string was attached to one end of this frame, and the other to a pin inserted into the opposite end. These pegs were inserted into such a way that they could be freely turned in their peg holes, and the strings attached to them were tightened or loosened in order to obtain the required number of vibrations. The many strings stretched from the left first joint, 39 were colored white, and the totality of vibrations, that is to say, the specific sound produced by the oscillations of each one of them, is called it, center of. Gravity of the octave, this specific sound corresponded to what your favorites now call each set of seven strings producing center of gravity sounds, or whole tones, then call them octave as it still is today. So in this way there were stretched on the apparatus, last first note, seven octaves of whole tones, the totality of the general consonants of which gave what is called the sacred pantheon note, just what the two great brothers had surmised, and which proved to coincide almost exactly with what, as I already said, they had named it, the general sound. Each of these octaves of strings on the last verse note gave the totality of vibrations which, according to the calculations of the great twin brothers, corresponded to the totality of vibrations of all the cosmic substances issuing from seven separate independent sources, substances that constitute one of the seven centers of gravity of the fundamental, growing cosmic antimonian octave. Each white string on the lab merch note was tuned separately by this Chinese learned being, King Dou-Chou, in such a way that it gave the average number of vibrations which, according to the calculations of the great brothers, ought to be present in the substances constituting one of the seven centers of gravity of the given totality of substances, which in its turn constitutes one of the seven centers of gravity of the fundamental cosmic octave of substances. Each octave, as well as each whole tone of the octave, had its own name. Thus, the highest octave of the string was called Archiepiodish. The second highest, Perthertiopen. The third highest, Adorniopen. The fourth highest, Teacheriopen. The fifth highest, Theodoriopen. The sixth highest, Bessoriopen. The seventh highest, Hopedoriopen. And the center of the gravity strings, which were colored white, had the same names in all octaves, with the addition of the name of the given octave. These whole tones were called thus. The first, the highest in the octave, Hadashianus. Second highest, Evatonus. Third highest, Dobertonus. Fourth highest, Micatonus. Fifth highest, Midotonus. Sixth highest, Duotonus. Seventh highest, Sonatonus. The contemporary beings of the earth now can be the same whole tones. Do, see,